vocation director for the Diocese of Lexington, and being the vocation director has given me an opportunity to visit the different parishes throughout the diocese, to introduce myself, and to encourage each of every parish to please pray for an increase to vocations to the priesthood and the religious life. It's an honor to be with you this morning. As always, when we gather, we begin with the sign of our salvation and our faith. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you came to reconcile us to one another and to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you heal the wounds of sin and division. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you intercede for us with your Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, say to those whose hearts are frightened, be strong, fear not. Here is your God. He comes with vindication, with divine recompense. He comes to save you. Then will the eyes of the blind be opened, the ears of the deaf be cleared. Then will the lame leap like a stag. Then the tongue of the mute will sing. Streams will burst forth in the desert and rivers in the steppe. The burning sands will become pools and the thirsty ground springs of water. The word of the Lord. Reading from the letter of St. James. My brothers and sisters, show no partiality as you adhere to the faith in our glorious Lord Jesus Christ. For if a man with gold rings and fine clothes come into your assembly, and a poor person in shabby clothes also comes in, and you pay attention to the one wearing the fine clothes and say, sit here, please, while you say to the poor one, stand there or sit at my feet. Have you not made distinction among yourselves and become judges with evil designs? Listen, my beloved brothers and sisters. Did not God choose those who are poor in the world to be rich in faith and heirs of the kingdom that he promised to those who love him? The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit. A
reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Again, Jesus left the district of Tyre and went by way of Sidon to the Sea of Galilee, into the district of the Decapolis.
And people brought to him a deaf man who had a speech impediment and begged him to lay his hand on him. He took him off by himself, away from the crowd. He put his finger into the man's ears and spitting touched his tongue. Then he looked up to heaven and groaned and said to him, "Ephphatha," that is, "be opened." And immediately the man's ears were opened. His speech impediment was removed, and he spoke plainly. He ordered them not to tell anyone, but the more he ordered them not to, the more they proclaimed it. They were exceedingly astonished, and they said, "He has done all things well. He makes the deaf hear and the mute speak." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Show no partiality. Those words come from our second reading from the letter of St. James. Unfortunately, that is not always how we live. We have a tendency to divide people into camps, but strip away all of the externals and we are all pretty much alike. We come in different packages, but at the core, we are all equal in the eyes of God. How would the church maintain itself if showing partiality became the rule rather than the exception? Suppose when it comes to the distribution of Holy Communion, I said, first, we will distribute communion to those dressed in designer clothing. Second, we will distribute communion to those dressed in casual clothing. If we start down that road, where would the distinctions stop? It seems to me that we make distinctions between people based upon some pretty flimsy and insignificant pretenses. If anyone has ever been on the receiving end of someone else's negative judgment, then we know how painful and degrading it can feel. When we dismiss others because of the clothes they are wearing, the color of their skin, their religious or political affiliation, their sexual orientation, because of some disability, or for whatever reason whatsoever, then we make distinctions among ourselves and we set ourselves up as judges. And unless we are God Almighty perfect, we might want to rethink that position. There is but one judge, and that is God. Instead of making distinctions that build walls, why not focus on what we have in common so that we can build a bridge between each other? After all, we share in one baptism. We are all challenged by the same word of God. At communion, we are all nourished by the body of Christ. The passage from the book of the prophet Isaiah and the passage from the Gospel of Mark speak about those who have had their ears and their eyes opened. But not only our eyes and our ears, but our hearts need to be opened as well. When we begin to understand with our hearts that we can show no partiality and can make no distinctions between us, then we begin to understand that our true worth comes from being a member of God's family. When we look beyond all of the external trappings and see each other as a brother or a sister in Christ, that will be the starting point of doing all things well.
Please stand and together let us. listened to the word of God, having professed our faith, let us now place our needs before our Heavenly Father.
For church leaders and all who are called to lives of service in imitation of Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who do not yet believe and all who have disdain for the church, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the unemployed, the underemployed, and the overworked, that all receive living wages for honest work, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a time of enduring peace for our Jewish brothers and sisters in the Holy Land and throughout the world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this community gathered here before you in faith, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the life of every human person from conception to natural death be protected in our laws and cherished in our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our benefactors, Our Lady of Perpetual Help, St. Paul, St. Bernard, St. Monica, and the Diocese of Lexington, may God continue to bless their generosity. Let us pray to the Lord.
Loving God, hear the prayers of your family before you. If it be your will, grant answers to our petitions. Open our eyes, our ears, and our hearts to see how we can help bring these petitions to fulfillment. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed
are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
And may your sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for all the Holy Church.
O God, who give us the gift of true prayer and of peace, graciously grant that through this offering we may do fitting homage to your divine majesty, and by partaking of the sacred mystery, we may be faithfully united in mind and heart through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And
with your spirit. Lift up your hearts.
And lift up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For by his birth he brought renewal to humanity's fallen state, and by his suffering canceled out our sins. By his rising from the dead, he has opened the way to eternal life, and by ascending to you, O Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and John, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the
Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things.
pray. Grant that your people, O Lord, whom you nourish and endow with life, through the food of your word and heavenly sacrament, may so benefit from your beloved Son's great gifts, that we may merit an eternal share in his life, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Are there any announcements to be made?
Wednesday, 11:30, we'll have a rosary.
CCD
classes begin October 3rd. I have an enrollment at 10:30, but it's up to 10 o'clock. So, October 3rd at 10 o'clock.
Since it was in the bulletin, the concert at Central Park in Ashland at 3 o'clock, due to advanced inclement weather forecast, has been canceled.
Okay. And we do have refreshments in the kitchen.
And I'd like to thank you all for being so welcoming. This is my first time to embrace the control of an extremely nice, very, very fine to me. And I'll see you next weekend because I'm filling in next weekend as well. Please continue to pray for vocations. If you know of any man who has the qualities or virtues of making a good priest, please give him my information or give me his information. I would reach out and contact him. We are trying to make a vocation office of the Diocese of Lexington more inclusive because we know that women also have vocations to religious life as well. So if you know of any woman who has, you think, the character or the virtues of leading a good religious life or consecrated life, please give her my information as well or give me her contact. I will reach out to her as well. We all have a vocation in this world, whether it's to holy matrimony or to the religious life of the priesthood. We all have a greater calling, a higher calling, so please continue to pray for an increase in vocations for priesthood, religious life. And again, thank you all so very much for your hospitality. You have made me feel very, very welcome. And for that, I thank you very much. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless each and every one of you, the Father and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.